Let's set the record straight. This is not an alien spaceship. Nor is it about to hit us and extinguish life on Earth as we know it. But that doesn't mean that all the excitement surrounding 3i Atlas is unfounded. On the contrary. 3i Atlas was first spotted by the Asteroid Terrestrial Impact Last Alert System Telescope in Chile on the 1st of June 2025. It quickly became clear that this object was special because rather than being on an elliptical orbit around the Sun, it followed an extreme hyperbolic trajectory, meaning that it must have originated in interstellar space. Unlike the vast majority of comets and asteroids we know, which originate in our own solar system. In fact, 3i Atlas is only the third interstellar interloper ever found, hence the designation 3i. The internet went crazy with all kinds of alien spaceship theories. But most scientists are very clear that 3i Atlas is most definitely a comet. After all, it has an icy nucleus surrounded by a bright cloud of gas and dust, and a tail, which is kind of a giveaway. So, what is all the fuss about? Let's ask an expert. Cyrielle Hopitome is an astronomer at the University of Edinburgh in Scotland and a former ESO fellow in Chile. She has observed 3i Atlas extensively.
We're basically seeing a piece of material that was formed around another star that had traveled for a very long time in interstellar space and that's now visiting us, where we can really study it and what it's made of. And that allows us to better understand planetary formation conditions in other planetary systems. So it's a very, very exciting thing to see.
Thanks to all this excitement, astronomers from around the world scrambled to follow up 3i Atlas with both ground and space-based telescopes as it made its way from the outer reaches of the solar system towards the Sun. These first observations threw in some surprises, fueling speculations about some form of alien involvement.
We've looked at 3i Atlas with the ESO Very Large Telescope, looking at the optical light, so the light we can see with our eyes, basically. What we saw is a lot of nickel, so that was very surprising. And the other surprise, sort of, that was that we detected nickel, but no iron. So usually they are detected together, and there we just saw the nickel.
But as the comet moved closer to the Sun and its heat and radiation, its atmospheric composition changed as expected, making it much more similar to solar system comets, at least in terms of its nickel to iron ratio. It also brightened considerably. Some people said that it did so in a strange way and took that as further proof of its alien spaceship nature. But according to Cyrielle, there is a natural, much simpler explanation.
One thing that happens in comets is that they have sudden brightening events. We don't actually always know why. Some people have hypothesized that you could have sort of pockets of gas, you know, where your pressure builds up and it sort of explodes at some point. And, you know, when it does, it releases a lot of material and it becomes much brighter all of a sudden. It could be fragmentation, you lose a little piece of the comets and then suddenly you have way more material exposed.
Another finding that was cited as evidence for the alien spaceship theory was the hint of a tail pointing towards rather than away from the Sun. But this can be understood in terms of standard physics.
What can happen is sometimes, so the dust can be emitted the sunward side of the comet because that's where the heat comes, right? And if the dust particles are quite big, the radiation pressure from the Sun might just not be strong enough to push it back. And that way you could have sort of a sunward facing jet.
And even the seemingly nonsensical observation that the comet appeared bluer, which in astronomy generally means hotter, than the Sun has a simple explanation.
So what happens often is when comets come close to the Sun, rather than seeing the dust, which is what we should really be comparing when we compare the color, we see the dust and gas. So the blue filters got a bit of a boost because they don't have only the dust, they got dust and gas in them. And so the comet appears blue, but it doesn't mean that the dust in it is any bluer than it was. So it might just be the contamination, and that's very expected when comets come close to the Sun.
So I think you see where I'm going with this, but just to be 100% clear.
So far, we do not see any indication that 3i Atlas is an alien spaceship. It looks like a comet, and comets are weird. All comets are very strange, including all solar system comets, and they all behave in a slightly different way. All of the information that we're getting so far it's a comet.
Phew, so now that we've got the alien spaceship noise out of the way, we can concentrate on why 3I Atlas is so interesting from a scientific point of view. Comets in general are considered fossils left over from the formation of their stellar systems. They're a bit like time capsules. By studying them, we can look back into the distant past and see how the planets that are there now were first formed. As already mentioned, 3I Atlas is only the third interstellar object found to visit us in our own solar system. And as such, it's a very rare messenger from another stellar system, one that may be significantly older than our own.
If we actually get a piece of material that was formed there, it's really, really interesting because we can now probe what it's really made of, rather than trying to look at exoplanets around these very old stars that are very far away and really hard to study.
And what's more, we got lucky and found it early on in its voyage around the Sun. The other two interstellar objects we observed so far, 1I Oumuamua and 2I Borisov, we found only as they were about to leave the solar system, which limited the amount of information we could gather on them. For the case of 3I Atlas, things are different. We already studied it as it approached the Sun and as it reached its closest point, perihelion. We can now continue to observe it as it moves away.
It's quite exciting about 3I Atlas, and we get way more measurements because so far it's the brightest one of the three interstellar objects we've observed. So the brightest they are, the more measurements we can make and the more we can try to understand the history of these objects and what they tell us about their home systems.
For the last few weeks, it's been challenging to observe 3I Atlas because it appeared close to the Sun as seen from Earth and was not visible during the nighttime. So there was a bit of a lull in the observations taken, even though space probes and telescopes that can observe during the day, such as ALMA, in which ESA is a partner, continued to monitor it. Now that it's emerging again during nighttime, we're holding our breath for new results. They have the potential to be more conclusive than what we've been able to get so far. For one, most observations of comets and interstellar objects so far have been taken after perihelion. So observing 3I Atlas in this phase means that we're finally comparing cosmic apples with apples, giving us an idea of how unusual it really is. Also, it may be only now that we're beginning to see the real 3I Atlas.
These objects might have spent so long in interstellar space. Basically, the upper layer of the object might have been transformed by cosmic ray. We have a chance that maybe on the other side of perihelion, the comet is going to have ejected some of these layers that have been processed, and we're going to see some more pristine material. We might start getting some more answers when we looked at it on the other side of perihelion.
While 3I Atlas is not an alien spaceship, it is a messenger from the depths of space and time that can provide invaluable evidence on how planets formed in other star systems. With all the telescopes we have monitoring the sky, we're bound to uncover more interstellar objects in the next years. And I think that we should remain open to one of them potentially at some point even being an alien spaceship. If there's scientific evidence for this, of course. In the meantime, let's appreciate our current interstellar visitor for what it is. And on this, I'll let Cyrielle have the last word.
Comets are all a bit weird and wonderful. Comets are like cats. They have tails and they do whatever they want. It seems like it's a little bit the case of 3I Atlas as well.